Talks.
Welcome everyone to Analytics in 15 series. My name is Mayank Agarwal. I'm a senior product manager at Amazon QuickSight. Today, I'm going to talk about how to easily integrate analytics into your applications using Amazon QuickSight Embedded. Today's, let me walk you through the agenda. We'll start with introduction. Why do you need embedded analytics? What does QuickSight provide? Then we will go into one-click embedding, which is a QuickSight way for you to embed dashboards or individual visuals within your application it doesn't take more than 5 minutes. No coding required. It's a seamless way. So we'll go through how to do it. I'll show a working demo. And then finally, I'll also show an embedded dashboard with QuickSight Q, which allows your readers or end users to be able to ask questions in natural language and get reply with visualizations. So let's get started. So QuickSight Embedded, right? Why do you need QuickSight Embedded? So QuickSight Embedded lets you embed analytics in the form of dashboards or visuals in your application. So your users don't have to leave the context of your application. They don't have to log in into some other tool. For them, it's a seamless experience. And it's with QuickSight Embedded, since it is serverless, it provides a very consistent high performance with any scale. So as your usage grows or your user base grows, QuickSight keeps up with that usage and continue to give a high performant and reliable experience to your end user. And finally, QuickSight is a usage-based pricing model, which means as depending on your usage any given month, you will only pay for that usage. So if you, let's say, 1 month you have 1,000 users versus a second month you have 500 users, you're not going to be paying. You will only be paying for 500 users for the second month. Some other key capabilities with QuickSight. So I just talked about serverless, so it scales with you as your usage grows. We have QuickSight Q, which provides ML insights, and your users can ask questions in natural language and get reply in form of visuals. We have something called Spice, which is in-memory database or data storage. So it lets you pull your data from your backend, let's say Redshift or SQL servers, and we store that in memory, which provides you high performance, super fast queries, and very low latency for your end users. And then we also have something called multi-tenancy. So if you have end customers who are independent of each other and you want to avoid having accidental data exposure, you can put them in their own tenants, and QuickSight has a way to set up a multi-tenancy, and then your users and their data is stored within their tenant. Themes is something where you can use, you can apply various themes to these dashboards or visuals, and these analytics will look like your application. So your end users will not have any, they will not leave the context of application. So they will look, for them, it's a seamless, it's part of your application. And then finally, we have APIs and SDKs. So if you prefer programmatic way of providing these capabilities to your end users, we support that with APIs and SDK as well. So now let's talk about one-click embedding. I'm gonna next few slides, I'll show you how to do it, and then at the end I will show a working demo end-to-end, which will basically go over these slides as well. So first thing you need to do, and this is QuickSight console. Now this can be within the QuickSight console, or we also offer console embedding where you can embed the authoring experience itself within your application. So either way, if you have a dashboard which you want to embed in your application, you go to the share screen, and again I'll show this how to get to it, but the share screen will let you add users or entities who will have access to this this analytics or dashboard, right? Over here you can add users via email or their username. You can also, if you see the toggle, two toggles on the bottom left, you can enable for everyone in the account depending on your use case and security needs. So that's the first step. You have to make sure users have access to it. Second step, which is the most critical step, and it's super important from security standpoint, is allow listing domains. So what it means is your application domain should be allow listed to be able to embed QuickSight dashboards and visuals. So if somebody good reasons or bad reasons have access to your embed code, they won't be able to use that embed code in their application and access your data unless their domain is allow listed here. I'll show how to set this up as well. And then finally, the last step, which is how to embed this. There is a copy embed code on the sharing screen. You can see that red arrow. You click on that, it's going to copy the code on your clipboard. And the bottom iframe code, what you see is you simply paste that into your HTML file, and that's all it is. It really is that simple. You copy the code, put it in your HTML, and the dashboard is available to your end user as long as they have access to the dashboard. Another thing you can do with QuickSight is you can embed visuals. So instead of full dashboard with, let's say, 30 visuals, you only want to present certain visuals to your end users. So within the visual menu, there is an embed visual option which presents you a copy code. So it's the same process. You copy the code, put it in the HTML file, and that visual will be available to your end users. And then finally, I will show, so this is QuickSight Q, which is, as I said in the beginning, it's a way for your end users to ask questions in natural language, and the reply is in form of visuals. Now, this is not possible through one-click copy code kind of process, but it is possible via APIs. I'm not going to be able to show the end-to-end demo for that, but I will show it. Show this page, and you can see it, how users can interact with it. And there's a way to embed this queue capabilities in your dashboard as well. So with that, let's go to a demo. Let's start the demo. I'll show it end to end, and I have a sample website application set up. So I'll start with that. All right. So this is a sample demo web page I have set up using AWS S3 and CloudFront. So imagine this is your website, your Salesforce portal, your internal wiki, could be anything. So the requirement or the use case here is that for my users, I want to be able to present them analytics within the context of this web page, instead of having them to go to QuickSight and log in there and open dashboards and go through those steps. So they should be able to come to this page and look at the data or analytics data they need to. So as you can see, there is nothing here. Now, let me do a recap. And so as in the slide I was showing, there's a share screen where you need to enable access. So I'm going to go. So this is a sample dashboard I have set up. So once I open the dashboard in QuickSight, there are sharing options. So I click on this link. I click on share dashboard. Now, this is the share screen. I can add more users here, invite them to this dashboard. I can enable access to everyone in this account, depending on your use case. You can do either or both or one. And then you can also make it discoverable in QuickSight, which means anybody who logs into QuickSight, it will be visible on their page as well. So this is the sharing screen. We'll come back here to copy this embed code. But the important piece, the security setting which we need to trigger, is in Manage QuickSight. This is the administration menu. On the left nav, you will see a bunch of options. For embedding, you can see here domains and embedding. So once you go here, now you see I don't have any domain whitelisted, allow listed here. So I need to add the domain where I will be embedding my dashboards or visuals. So if I go back to this domain, the page I have created, this is the link. I'm going to enter, copy paste the domain here. I'm going to remove the HTML piece. And if needed, I can include subdomains as well. For me, it's just a single web page right now, so it really doesn't matter. And then just simply add. Now our security is in place. If anybody gets hold of the embed code, unless they have access to your HTML, they won't be able to use that embed code within their own applications. Right. So I'm going to go back to the dashboard, go back to the sharing screen, and copy embed code. See, it gets copied to clipboard. Now I'll open up the HTML file. So you see this HTML file only has an image, which is the banner on top you saw. I'm going to copy paste this iframe code. The page width I have set up is 1395, so I'm just going to change the width, that's all. And I'm going to save this file. And I'm going to go back to S3. So S3 is where I have set up this website or this demo page. I'm going to upload this file. Okay, I need to be able to share this. Yeah. So I'm going to upload this file over in S3. Just bear with me. This is the HTML file we just updated. I'm going to upload. And I'm going to go back to the web page and refresh it, and the dashboard should be visible here. There you go. So it's really that simple. You share the dashboard with users, you allow list the domain, you copy the code, put it in HTML, and that's all it takes. Your dashboard is visible to your end users. Okay, so once the dashboard, as you see how easy it is to embed these dashboards, it's not limited to just the image, or it's not just a plain PNG file or JPEG file. Your users can actually interact with these dashboards and visuals depending on their needs. So for example, they can maximize the visual. They can also export the data in the visual as a CSV. They can view the summary data. They can look at individual data points, get more details. All the interactions which is available within QuickSight console is also available as part of the embedding. They can hover over things. They can it's super interactive experience, and it can give your readers seamless end-to-end experience without having to go outside of your application context. Right. Now let's do quickly. What if it was just a visual? If you want to just put this top chart on this page, not the full dashboard. So if I go back to the dashboard here, within the visual menu, I have embed visual. I can use copy code and same steps. I'm going to go back to HTML, copy this code I just created, change the width, which was just my custom width size, page size. Save it. Then I'm going to update the HTML file in my S3 bucket. And upload this file. Then once I go here, once I refresh, you will only see the visual we just embedded. We just want to show. That's all. So it's really, really that straightforward. There is no coding required. If you're doing a POC, you want to play with it, you can do it within minutes without writing a single piece of code, single line of code. The last thing I wanted to show is with QuickSight Q, how does this, how the dashboard looks. The steps for QuickSight Q are a little bit, they involve more coding. You need to call the API. There is detailed documentation and blog post how to do that. But I wanted to present that that it is possible that with QuickSight Q, where your users, so these are some sample questions. Your users can ask questions in plain English language, and they will get the reply by visual. So if I click on this, show me sales by month, it's gonna present me a visual with the response. So your users don't have to do any filtration. They don't have to figure out any, go to a particular visual, dig deeper. They can simply ask questions using plain English language, and get their analytics needs done, fulfilled. That's all I have today. Thank you for joining. Appreciate it. Happy to take any questions.